Today I want to show you how I created this look inspired by Luna from Sailor Moon. So the first thing that I did is apply a smoothing primer because of course anime characters have smooth skin. And then I am going to apply a liquid foundation. Then I'm going to conceal under my eyes and any dark spots that I have. I'm using a couple concealers to get my right shade match. Using my beauty blender, I'm just going to blend all of it out and then wipe away any excess under the eyes because it usually creases for me. And then I'm going to set everything with powder very carefully, not moving around the foundation. Once I set everything with a powder puff, I go over with a big fluffy brush just to sweep it all over the place, and that's what I like to do. Then of course, I'm going to contour my face and I'm going to contour the sides of my face as well as my cheekbones. And then of course the forehead to slim it out, add some color because as you can see, I look very washed out, but that is because my camera does not like me sometimes. Then I'm going to carve out my nose, give it more of a pinched look, and also make the tip look nice and round because I like that look. And then of course I'm going to highlight down the bridge, and I like to do a line and a dot, so an exclamation point. Using a pink blush, you could use a peach. This is one of my favorites. I'm using a duofiber because it applies the blush really softly and I can build on it and it doesn't apply patchy at all. To make the nose look even more pinched, I'm going to apply a translucent powder down the sides and then sweep it away right away. I don't let it bake because it looks too dry sometimes. And then I'm going to highlight my cheekbones to give it some dimension, of course, my favorite part. Moving on to the eyebrows, I didn't overdraw my eyebrows because anime characters have pretty thin eyebrows. So I'm just using my dip brow pomade and making it look as natural as possible. And I'm going to set that with a tinted brow gel. After I prime the eyelids, I'm going to just set them with a beige shade. It's like a light yellow, and then I decided to go for a dusty mauve color. Not sure why, I was just really feeling it. So I put that in the crease and blended it out, and I'm applying a very shimmery liquid eyeshadow on my eyelid to make it look bigger. And with these ones from Steel, you want to apply them one at a time. Then I'm going to line my eyes with liquid eyeliner, and I did do a double wing, which is quite fun because anime characters usually have like a lot of wings, maybe. It's just me. I made that up. For under the eyes, I am contouring. I'm making my eyes look a little puffy. It did look kind of weird in my photos, but on camera it looked fine, and I decided to blend it out a little bit, not make it look too harsh. This is a thing that I've seen people do, and I like the way it looks sometimes. So of course, you're going to try to make your eyelashes look as long as possible. I even added falsies just on the ends to make them look even more anime-like, and I really love the magnetic lashes. They're so easy to use. For the lips, I used a blush color and it was lip gloss, very simple. And the trickiest part of this look was the moon. So I went and used a gold eyeliner, and then on top of it, I used a glitter. And for the bangs, I just curled the fronts in because I had to fake bangs. For the bun buns, I just used a sock and one of those bun bun things. So that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I had so much fun recreating this look. It's been a long time coming. I will see you guys in the next video.